Our All-Metro defense is led by Wyzetta's Marion Barber III. Watch Barber number 23 pick off Creighton Durham Hall quarterback Joe Maurer twice during a game in mid-October. The 5'11", 195-pound senior has 9 interceptions on the season, and his coach says he may be the best defensive back in Minnesota.
I know the college scouts feel he could be a very good Division I defensive back, and our defensive coach agrees with that.
Barber can hit, too. Watch this shot. He's a definite impact player on defense. He's also one of the Metro's best running backs. Watch him bust loose on this touchdown run. The senior has rushed for 1,614 yards and 22 touchdowns. Wyzetta won the Classic Lake and advanced to the state semifinals. Marcus Levesser did it all for Bloomington Kennedy. On defense, Levesser finished with 76 tackles and 3 interceptions in leading Kennedy to a 5-5 season. The senior really transformed the Eagles' attitude, leading by example. He rarely left the field.
I'm used to it because last year I was in almost every snap of the game. It's almost like a routine for me.
You got to watch him play one time, and it's evident. With 22 players on the field at a time, there's one kid that sticks out, and it's usually Marcus.
From his quarterback spot, Levesser accounted for 2,000 yards of offense and was involved in 26 touchdowns. Eden Prairie's Garrett Smuggard is a big-time player who steps up when games matter most. Watch Smuggard intercept this pass. He has 6 on the season and 16 in his career. Smuggard leads an Eagle defense, which is giving up only 160 yards of offense per game. The senior can hit, too. Watch this shot. He was a first-team All-Metro choice last season. Burnsville safety Clint Walters at 6'1", 190 is a big hitter for the Blaze. Watch the impact the senior makes on this play. Walters recorded 109 tackles, 63 solos, forcing 3 fumbles. He also intercepted 3 passes in leading Burnsville to the section finals and a 7-4 record. Egan defensive back Jordan Wilkie had a big season for the 8-2 Wildcats. Wilkie is a ball hawk. He picked off a school record 9 passes, adding 10 pass breakups and 3 forced fumbles. Wilkie made 33 tackles in leading Egan to the number 1 seed in Section 5. Our All-Metro defensive line is led by Gopher recruit Rob Kramer at 6'5", 280 pounds. Watch the big hit by number 85. The Forest Lake senior is the Twin Cities Suburban Defensive Player of the Year. Kramer finished with 11 sacks and 12 other tackles for losses. He also recovered 3 fumbles. On offense, Kramer made 6 catches for 111 yards and scored 2 touchdowns in leading Forest Lake to a 7-3 season. Blaine Sam Berg is one big defensive tackle at 6'3", 350 pounds. Watch Berg number 72 make the big hit on this play. Berg was the Northwest Suburban Conference Defensive Lineman of the Year, and he was double-teamed almost every play. The big run stuffer finished with 54 tackles, 6 for losses. The senior 2-year starter led Blaine to a 10-1 season. Eden Prairie senior tackle Andrew King is the leader of one of the state's best defenses. Watch King number 66 on this play. He fights off the block, then gets up and makes the tackle. The 6'1", 250-pounder has 65 tackles, including 16 for losses. Watch King make the sack on this play. Eden Prairie head coach Mike Grant says King is special because he's the defensive signal caller from his line position. Eden Prairie defensive end Jason Peterson also makes our All-Metro team. He's big at 6'4", 240. Watch Peterson number 95 with the sack. He leads the Eagles defense with 13. Mike Grant says Peterson's size and speed makes him one of the most athletic defensive ends in the state. Peterson's a key reason why the Eden Prairie Eagles allow just 80 yards passing per game and only 8 points per game. Totino Grace tackle Matt Smooty is one reason why the Eagles finished 10-1 this season. Watch the big hit by Smooty, number 58. He finished with 53 tackles, 22 for losses, including 6 sacks. The 6'1", 230-pound senior has been a standout player the past 2 years. Watch Smooty pick off the pass for a touchdown against Cambridge. He's considered one of the best players in the North Suburban Conference. Matamidi's Tony Madlin rounds out our All-Metro defensive line. Watch Madlin make the hit on this play to force the fumble. The 255-pound senior had 56 tackles, 23 for losses, and 5 sacks. Coon Rapids senior Digger Anderson at 6'1", 215 leads our All-Metro linebackers. Watch Anderson, number 40, shoot the gap and make the big tackle for a loss. Digger made 192 tackles, almost 24 per game. Anderson is Coon Rapids' all-time tackle leader and was the defensive player of the year in the Northwest Suburban Conference. Digger credits much of his mobility to his years of dance. Anderson is a national champion dancer and says he stays in great shape year-round thanks to his efforts in the studio. Our other All-Metro linebacker is Egan Jr. Lawrence Pinson at 6'2", 225. Watch the big hit by Pinson on this play. He recorded 46 solo tackles, 5 for losses, and 1 sack in leading a very tough Egan defense. Pinson is the younger brother of Larry Pinson, who plays for the Gophers. Our All-Metro punter is Maple Grove's Mr. Everything, Jacob Johnson. Johnson punted 45 times for an average of 37 yards. His punting helped the Crimson establish excellent field position all season. But the 6'2", 190-pound Johnson does more than punt. He made 41 catches for 883 yards and 9 touchdowns in leading Maple Grove to an 8-3 season. And our All-Metro specialist is Hopkins' Dan Bowling, who flat out did it all. Bowling returned 2 kickoffs for touchdowns and 2 punts for scores. On offense, he made 59 catches for 991 yards and 12 touchdowns. On defense, he picked off 6 passes. The 5'8 senior had an outstanding season.